It was my first weekend with the family in quite a while. That university case was driving me mad. I tried to relax, canoeing on the lake. It all happened so long ago now. Sometimes I forget, and then I catch myself in the mirror. Deep down, I know they're still alive. I mean, I don't really know. How could I? I don't even understand why I keep looking for them. But what else can I do? It's my life. Kids going missing in Gloomy Ditch. Yeah, what else is new? So what are you doing here, Smith? What brings you to the filthiest part of this godforsaken town? Well, anyway, you needed a bit of fresh air. Not sure taking this gun with me is a good idea, though. I promised Helen I'd never use it.
Thank you. Hmm?
What I really need now is a long, hot shower. Look at this place. That guy dressed as a clown makes me want to puke. How many kids did they manage to kidnap like that before sending them who knows where? This delivery slip thing has to be a clue. Old man Scarlet ruled over Gloomywood. They say he built this concrete eyesore right in the middle of town to celebrate the birth of his daughter. You gotta be real rich to come up with an idea like that. Honestly, I never thought I'd wind up here. This town, rotten to the bone. Even the big shots are up to their neck and shit. Now, how do I get into this fortress?
Thank you. Thank you.
Smith, you left a hell of a mess at Scarlet Tower. So much for being discreet, genius. The newspapers will be all over this like flies on roadkill. But there's no way I'm stopping now. How many kids?
Hmm?
Old man Scarlet ruled over Gloomywood. They say he built this concrete eyesore right in the middle of town to celebrate the birth of his daughter. You gotta be real rich to come up with an idea like that. Hospice. Clearly not the first place anyone would come looking for missing kids. But what's the real link between Dr. Miguele and Scarlet, apart from this scary-looking doll and this picture? I'm gonna have to take a look at this hospice, though. The anonymous message I received shows I am onto something. What if Sandra and Martin are in there? Whoa, Smith. You're going off the rails, dude. Been 7 years since they disappeared. Do you even recognize them now?
Thank you.
A hospice. Clearly not the first place anyone would come looking for missing kids. But what's the real link between Dr. Me?
Thank you. Thank you.
poor kids. Those ones almost got it in the neck. Chopped into pieces, sent around the world. I'll let Detective Conrad and his jackasses finish things off. Turns out I'm pretty pleased I managed to stop that nutjob, Miguele. Tip. At least now I know Garrett's not to be trusted. But hey, who can I trust anyway? That doctor's case I found at the clinic is about the last clue I have. Thank you. Lousy tip. At least now I know Garrett's not to... Should have brought my old umbrella. Fucking lousy weather. Wonder what kind of sicko I'm gonna find next. And why do they always go for kids? Here we are, number 240. What a stench. How can anyone live in a place like this? Where's that awful smell coming from?
Thank you. Thank you. Hmm? Hmm?
Blood. I'll never get it out. Damn, I really like this shirt. Those pig masks were so stupid. A whole family of fucked up retards. Can't believe what I just saw. And were they really selling the meat? Who to? I don't want to sound paranoid, but there's got to be a link between all these psychopaths. So, what's common to a talentless clown, the town's richest heiress, a surgeon who smuggles vital organs, and a family of cannibals, apart from a sick attraction to children? Sure. one or two whiskeys, why not? Didn't even have time to get... The same ticket I found at the Norman place. Illegal fighting in the kennels at a scrapyard? Perhaps Garrett's tip wasn't so bad this time. Perhaps my luck's about to change at last. If you can call any of this luck, more like a curse. Never been around here before. Really out in the sticks. My feet are covered in mud. Helen used to enjoy our walks in the forest. Me? Hated them. All that fucking forest. You have to be a squirrel or a psycho to want to live here.
Hmm?
Between that pervert from the TV and those crazies dressed up as scouts, it's been a pretty entertaining night. But things are getting complicated now. Those nutjobs didn't kidnap all those kids just for dogfights, or even to train them as little soldiers, because they were all really young. And that old mummy in the wheelchair. Seems like I've seen that ugly mug before. In any case, he's out to get me. But I'm gonna get you first, big fella. Wake up, Smith. The Mermaid's Tavern won't just drop the solution into your lap every time. And drinking yourself stupid every night ain't gonna help find your kids. Still, somehow, I feel like I'm getting closer. That ugly guy in the wheelchair. Where the hell have I seen him before? Must have been a long, long time ago.
Thank you.
Between that pervert from the TV and those crazies dressed up as scouts, it's been a pretty entertaining night. But things are getting complicated now. Wow. Looks like they won first prize designing a horror movie set. No lights. Watch out, Smith. Sandra and Martin might be inside. But little Emmy, for sure.
Thank you. Ha! Oh. Thank you. Hmm?